and welcome. I'm Prachi Gupta. As the whole world battles the coronavirus pandemic, every single day is bringing in hope. Hope of a breakthrough. Hope of a new vaccine. In this COVID-19 bulletin, we bring you facets of that hope. Curated information on the new developments in science and technology each day that can help us in managing and overcoming the ongoing crisis. As many Indian states plan to relax lockdown guidelines, two new disinfection sprayer units developed by Durgapur-based CSIR Central Mechanical Engineering Research Institute or CMERI are holding a new promise about disinfecting public places with high contamination potential, both indoors and outdoors. Named as battery-powered disinfectant sprayer and pneumatically operated mobile indoor disinfection, these units are effective in sanitizing frequently touched surfaces like tables, doorknobs, light switches, handles, desks, and so on. This will reduce the spread of coronavirus infection through fomite transfer. Both these sprayers have two-stage spraying units, separate storage tanks, and a number of fixed and flexible nozzle sets to disinfect indoor areas. The pneumatically operated system is made of steel frames mounted on four wheels and comprises compressors, piping, fittings, spray nozzle, and a storage tank of 10 liters. The battery-powered unit, however, consists of a cordless machine with a two-nozzle spray system, an extended arm spray unit, battery backup time of 4 hours, and a storage capacity of 20 liters. The researchers are further trying to incorporate a 360-degree coverage for disinfectants and cleaning spray and make units more compact for usage in schools and homes.
I have been going through the COVID guidelines, and what I have understood that indoor units needs to be disinfected frequently, and particularly in hospitals. And also I observed that when we are giving instruction to clean the knob, clean the railing, clean the table, and I observed also that people who are being employed for this purpose, or they have been requested for this purpose, they often come with a spray system, they spray and immediately wipe. I observed and it takes maximum 10 seconds for them to spray and wipe that area. Then there was some sort of discussion that that's not effective. How do we go with effectiveness? We have also a sprayer system which can be utilized for disinfecting the indoor system. But that is also a limitation, is that we have only one tank. Either we can go with the cleaning or we can go with the disinfection. No new guidelines, CDC says very clearly, it has to be cleaning and then disinfecting. Disinfectant will not work if the surface is not clean. It will not work with the dirt. It will not work with the other kind of debris. So we need to go with the two stages. Why not we try to make a machine which can reduce the subjectivity? Otherwise, it depends on the person to person, how they are cleaning, how they are disinfecting. So that's why we made a two machine. One is for the big lawns or the indoor systems where we have a big mess hall. Another one is smaller one, which is a battery operated, which can run for the 2 to 4 hours. Recently, we have transferred a technology also to one of the small scale industry. Reason being that we need to help small scale industries in a big way. They should turn out to be independent. They are manufacturing and selling the product. That is what we want. So that's why we transfer the technology, keeping that in mind. And we have also order of the couple of wheelchairs. Now I hear the word wheelchair is coming because first request came from a hospital. They want this unit for their cleaning staff. So that's why we have kept in a wheelchair. It is easy to move. And we in the long distance can be travel easily, but now the request also is coming from industry. Can it be trolley mounted? So we are also making a trolley mounted.
To serve the country in this time of crisis, the Guwahati-based National Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research, or NIPER, which is an institute under the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, has come up with two products. The first product is a 3D printed hands-free object that allows a person to open or close doors, windows, switch buttons, press elevator buttons, and several other such tasks without touching them with hands. This product will also allow people to carry out daily tasks without using bare hands, evading the risk of catching the infection. The second product is a 3D printed antimicrobial face shield which can control the spread of novel coronavirus. This face shield was designed after a thorough study to understand how viruses spread through oral, ophthalmic, olfactory, and other body cavities. Apart from being safe, the newly developed face shield is pocket friendly, easy to wear, chemically stable, non-fragile, and is easy to clean with the sanitizer or any alcoholic disinfectant. NIPER is manufacturing these products in collaboration with Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. These products, which help evade infection, become all the more important now, as many Indian states are considering to resume economic activities. Let's hear more about these two products from Dr. U.S.N. Murthy, who is the director at the NIPER Guwahati.
It is drawn the attention of one more public sector unit under Government of India, same under my ministry only, Department of Pharmaceuticals, Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. And they have come forward to manufacture it in the Pimpri Chinchwada Pune workshop in a large scale. And we have entered into MOU with them, and they are going to take care for the large scale production. As far as the cost benefit analysis is concerned, we are looking to the first of all societal application rather than commercial things, because the situation is alarming. If I look for the cost effect analysis, people who are going to use, they are residing, my target population is the poor and below average economic level people who are residing the endemic zones of the COVID.
The Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, the International Institute of Information Technology, or IIIT Hyderabad, and Intel India have come together in the fight against coronavirus. The joint venture will work to make testing for coronavirus infection and sequencing of coronavirus faster and cheaper. This will help in understanding the epidemiology and artificial intelligence-based risk stratification for patients with comorbidities. In this collaborative project, CSIR Labs will work with various hospitals and diagnostic chains in carrying out comprehensive diagnostics. IIIT Hyderabad will develop risk stratification algorithms that can help in drug and vaccine discovery, and Intel India will develop an end-to-end system that consists of multiple applications, testing devices, data collection, aggregation, gateways, a data exchange SDK, and an AI model hub platform. That is all for today. We will be back with another edition of COVID-19 Bulletin soon. We hope that you all are safe, sound, and staying at home. See you soon. Namaskar.